guys, welcome to Vedantu Neet English. I'm Diksha Kaushal, your chemistry master teacher. So guys, today we are going to convert minutes into marks by doing naming reactions, which are very, very important from the point of view of NEET and boards as well. Okay, so guys, let us start with the first question, that is soda lime decarboxylation. So guys, soda lime decarboxylation, why soda lime? Because here we have used caustic soda and quicklime. We have used the sodium salt of carboxylic acid here, which will be getting converted into alkane and Na2CO3. Okay, so this is getting converted into R, and this particular has RH. But in case of Cole's electrolysis, the same thing is getting converted into R and R. Always remember this thing. This is RH and this is RR. Okay, the alkyl part is getting doubled here. Here the alkyl part has just addition of hydrogen here. Okay, so now next thing is, in the Cole's electrolysis we have sodium salt of carboxylic acid and electricity is passed through that. So now what are the compounds that are formed on anode and cathode? At anode we have alkane and carbon dioxide, and at cathode we had hydrogen gas, and this is a basic medium because of NaOH. That's it. And also this proceeds through free radical mechanism. So next is Wood's reaction, Wood's fatigue reaction, all are same. The Na will take out X and X with itself in the presence of dry ether and heat. Why dry ether? Because sodium is very reactive, right? Okay, so now next is, this R and this R part will combine together to form R and R. In case of Wood's reaction, you have both the alkyl R. Actually, halo alkane, because we have alkane part here, and in this case we have one aryl part and one part is alkyl. Okay, so in the similar manner they will combine together and form this particular thing. And after that, in fatigue reaction, both the halide parts are aryl. Okay, these both are aryl and will have the formation of biphenyl here. Now next is Frankland reagent. In case of Na, we use zinc here. So zinc, you can also remember this with the help of Germany, and Germany has Frankfurt there. So in case of this, Frankland has Zn. Okay, so now also this Zn will take away X and X, and there will be combination of R and R, will have the formation of alkane and Zn X2 here, right? These all are the almost same methods here. Almost same method is being used here, right? Okay, so that's why I have put these question together. So now this is Corey House synthesis. Here we use Gilman's reagent. Okay, always remember this is an organometallic. This is not Grignard's reagent. That is RMGX. This is Gilman's reagent. This can also be used, or either in place of this, they can also give LiCUX and RX here. So here we have RX is getting converted into alkane. Okay, their side products are RCU and LiX. Right? So next is Sabatier-Sanderson reaction. Here we have alkene or alkyne that will be converted into alkane with the help of a catalyst, that is nickel, and this hydrogenation will take place here. Okay? So now, for alkene conversion, we use around 200 degrees Celsius, and for alkyne, we have around 300 degrees Celsius temperature. Right, so next is Darzan reaction. Like a Tarzan movie, this is the Darzan reaction. Okay, so Darzan reaction and Reed's reaction are almost similar. Let us see. In case of Darzan reaction, you have, this is thionyl chloride. Okay, this is thionyl chloride, right? Always remember this. This is thionyl chloride, and we use pyridine here. If we are not using pyridine, then this will follow intramolecular substitution reaction. Okay, so now thionyl chloride is used here, and the OH part will be replaced by Cl, and we'll have byproduct SO2 and HCl, which will vaporize. So this is a very good method of preparing alkyl halides, right? So next is Reed's reaction. Reed's reaction is almost similar. Just see this. This is not thionyl chloride. This is SO2Cl2. That means this is sulfonyl chloride. Okay, this is sulfonyl chloride, and here in the Darzan reaction we have taken the reactant as alcohol, and here the reactant is alkane, and this H will be replaced by this Cl. Rest is same. This will vaporize and the RCl will be formed here, right? So next is Clemmensen reduction. For Clemmensen reduction, we have carbonyl group here. For Clemmensen and Wolff-Pichenor reduction, both are same. There's just a difference of reagents and conditions, okay? So here, this is acidic condition. Always remember this. This is acidic condition. And here the question is being asked, then if you have another group. Like, for example, you have another group like OHF or you have COHF, right? So this OH will have the reaction over this because this is acidic condition. This is a base. So neutralization reaction will occur here and this will be get replaced to Cl. But on the acidic group, there will be no reaction because the conditions are already acidic. Okay, so these kind of questions can be asked. Here we use the reagent as zinc amalgam and HCl. The acidic conditions are to be noticed here. And in Bohr-Kirchner reduction, we have basic condition, always remember. In this case, also we have carbonyl group that is being reduced here. But in this case, the OH will group has no effect and the COH group will get converted into, so we have these will be converted into OH, okay? So, this is the another thing that is additional that is being asked in the question. For detail of these kind of questions, you can always, I will always recommend my detailed videos or one-shot videos or live lectures where these questions are being solved in those lectures, okay? So, now this is a quick revision. Right, so this is a Falkenstein reaction. This is halogen exchange reaction, right? Okay, so Falkenstein reaction, Schwartz reaction are actually halogen exchange reaction. So this halogen can be chlorine or this can be bromine. So here we have used Na in presence of acetone and this is getting converted into Ri, okay? Because this is a reversible reaction if you are using standard methods. That is why this particular reaction is used this way, right? So this is Schwartz reaction. In Schwartz reaction, we use inorganic fluoride. This is also halogen exchange method. So this also X can be Cl or Br. And then this can be halogen is being replaced by fluorine in presence of inorganic fluoride. Otherwise, this formation of RF is a very explosive reaction. So this is done this way. Okay. So now, next is Borodin-Hans-Dieker reaction, okay? The name is so heavy. So what we'll do here? Here we have silver, okay? This is silverish reaction. So what do we do here? Here we have RCOAG, okay? Silver salt of carboxylic acid and this Br2CCl4. So now always remember this. In this case, so always students get confused in this reaction, an HVZ reaction. In that reaction, the alpha hydrogen is being replaced. I'll also take that reaction as well. Here, in presence of Br2 and CCl4, this whole part is this Cl2, this CO2 goes out, Ag bar goes out, and this Br is being attached here. This is RBr. Okay, I was speaking Goa here. Why I am missing Goa? I don't know. I have never been there. Yeah. Okay. So now this is RBr. Okay, this is RBr. Do not confuse this with HBZ reaction. Okay. So next is Gatterman reaction. Gatterman reaction, as you can see, here in this reaction, we have, this is diazonium salt that is prepared from aniline, okay? That is prepared from aniline, 0 to 5 degrees Celsius, HNO2, okay? So now, here we have reacted this with HBr and copper powder. In Sandmeyer's reaction, this is sand and this is salt. Always remember, sand is salt, sand is salty. So in Sandmeyer's reaction, a salt is used, okay? Salt of copper is used. But in Gatterman reaction, you use copper powder. That is the only difference. Everything else is same. This is getting converted into bromobenzene and N2 and Cl2 is extracted out. And this is not very important. Cyanide is not formed here. This is not formed here. Cyanide is not formed here. Okay. Cyanide is not here. But here in this case, cyanide is formed, okay, with the help of CuCN and KCN. We cannot say that this is a Sandmeyer's reaction. This is a kind of, okay, this is a similar type, okay, this is a similar game that happens here. So next is Bahl-Schiemann reaction. In case of Bahl-Schiemann reaction, again, we have this aniline that is getting converted into diazonium salt. And after this is the diazonium salt, and this diazonium salt, we have added HBF4. Then this will get converted into, we will have fluorobenzene here. Okay, this is N2, then BF3-4. Because in very simpler manner, fluorobenzene is very explosive reaction. It's very difficult to make. So that is why we have used this particular reaction here. Okay, so next is Kolb's reaction. Now, the mechanism itself is very important. What we have done here, this is the salicylic acid. Okay, this is formed here. And this is NaOH, okay. Phenol is getting converted into salicylic acid. Okay, this is acid, not aldehyde. This is acid. Okay, here we have used CO2. This is the main hero of your reaction. This is the main hero of your reaction. This will act as a electrophile. And then we acidify it, we get salicylic acid. And the next reaction is similar to this. That is Remmert-Eimer reaction. the intermediate formed here is also very important. That is, what is the intermediate? That is dichloro. That is dichloro. Dichloro, what? Carbene. Okay, dichloro. Carbene is the intermediate here. If you are using CaCl3 aqueous NaOH phosphate, you will get salicylaldehyde. And if you are using CCl4, you will get the formation of salicylic acid here. That is the difference. Okay, this is also dimethylamine reaction, but CCl4 is being used here. Right. So next is Williamson reaction. Williamson reaction. We have see Williamson synthesis is different. Williamson reaction. Okay. So now Williamson synthesis or reaction. We say this is RX and this is RONA. So now this reaction. If I tell you, if they are going to ask some question from ether, either they are going to ask this Williamson synthesis or they are going to ask the reaction of ether with HX. That's it. No other reaction is going to ask. Okay. So this is also very, very important. With the help of so many examples, they will ask you this question. So obviously, you should do the example of these as well. Right. So this X will go with this Na and you will have the formation of this ether. That is ROR. Okay. So next is Rashig reaction. I won't say this is a very important reaction, but I have also included this reaction, right? Because this is one of the naming reactions, but I won't say very, very important. But yes, still can be asked directly in the exam, but not through examples, right? So this is chlorobenzene and this is what you have added here. This is calcium phosphate at 698 Kelvin and you have phenol formation here. Next is dose process. Again, a very important process of preparation of phenol. Here, the temperature and the pressure condition is very important. The temperature here is 623 Kelvin temperature. Okay. So, chlorobenzene, this bond is very difficult to break. Very difficult to break. But still, under drastic condition, we have did that. And we have converted chlorobenzene to phenol. Okay. So, when you are... One another question that can be asked from this particular reaction, that is if there is NO2 group on ortho, meta or para position, what happens? Okay, so that is also mentioned in your NCERT, so do read that. And also I have mentioned those in my detailed videos, my detailed lectures. You will find these kind of questions and a lot of practice question as well. So guys, now we have Helmholtz-Zelensky reaction. Oh my God, this is so scary. Right? This is simply named as HVZ reaction. Here also we have carboxylic acid. Do not confuse this by Borodin-Hunsaker reaction. So here we have CH3COH and here this alpha hydrogen. This alpha carbon, this is the alpha hydrogen. This alpha hydrogen will be replaced by chlorine in presence of chlorine and red phosphorus and water. That's it, okay? So now next reaction is Stefan reduction. Stefan reduction, you have tin chloride here. Okay, any metallic halide can be used here, right? So this is the cyanide and this is getting converted into aldehyde. Okay, cyanide is getting converted into aldehyde in the Stefan's reduction. Then we have Rosenman reduction. For Rosenman reduction and Birch reduction, always remember this one thing. In this case, you have Rosenman reduction and here there should be hydrogen here. This should be hydrogen, okay? This is again acid chloride is being converted into aldehyde. Okay, I'm getting a little fumble. I'm fumbling here. Just wait. Oh. So now here, acid chloride is getting converted into aldehyde. Right? So what is the catalyst here? This is called Lind-Lars catalyst. The BSO4 is the poison here. There can be other poisons as well, that is COCO3 or there can be quinoline. Anything can be used here as a poison here, because otherwise this reaction can be very vigorous. To stop that reaction, we added a poison here. So this is named as Lind-Lars catalyst. Also, another example of Lind-Lars catalyst is that if you use Lind-Lars catalyst, if you are using it on alkyne, then this will be getting converted into cis alkene. Okay, this is cis alkene. Okay, this will get converted into cis alkene with the help of Lind-Lars catalyst. And if you are going to convert alkyne into trans alkene, you must use Birch reduction. That is Li or Na in presence of liquid ammonia. That is Birch reduction. Okay. So now next is Gattermann-Koch reaction. So Gattermann and Gattermann-Koch reaction are different from each other. So this is Gattermann-Koch reaction. In this we have benzene and we are going to, okay. Otherwise we used to use Friedel-Crafts acylation, okay, but this group is not very stable. This particular group is not stable. This is very unstable. Okay, this is very unstable species. So we cannot use Friedel-Crafts acylation here. So instead, here we have used, this is the preparation method of this particular group, which is not stable. So here we have used carbon monoxide HCl anhydrous AlCl3 and we have this CH2 group on the benzene ring. Right. So now next is Etard's reaction. In Etard's reaction, you have almost just 6 reactions are left here. Okay. So you have this toluene and CrO2, Cl2, CH2 in presence of this CH2. You have the conversion of CH3 into CHO. Okay. This is Etard's reaction. Directly this can be, direct question can be asked from this reaction. You can see your PYQs. These questions are being asked in the PYQs that are very direct, very easy, very scoring questions. Okay. So next is Hoffman bromamide degradation. Again, so see, here you have, this is the actually, so this is RCONH2, this CO, this simple way of remembering this, this CO will be gone. This CO will be gone. That's it. Okay. This is RCONH2. Amide will be, this is for the formation of 1 degree amine. Okay, this is 1 degree amide will be getting converted into 1 degree amine. This is only for 1 degree. Okay, so this 1 degree amide will be getting converted into 1 degree amine. That is Hoffman bromamide degradation. Okay, so you have used Br2 KOH here. Either you can also use KOBr here. Anything can be mentioned in this place. Okay, again a very direct and important question. Now you have Hoffman analysis. Now this is a question that can be asked through examples, right? So otherwise this is a very simple reaction. This can be asked through examples. So you have the excess of RH. First it will get reacted with NH3, then it will form 1 degree. Again it will react with NH3, then form 2 degree. Again with NH3 it will form 3 degree. Again with NH3 it will form quaternary salt. Okay, that is RON positive, right? So next is Gabriel phthalamide synthesis. Oh my god, this seems like Gabbar. Okay, so this is Gabbar only. You can see the shuttle is like, the face is like Gabbar. So now you can see what will happen here. This is the formation of 1 degree. This is just for 1 degree amine. This is for 1 degree amine. Firstly, what will happen? We use alcoholic KOH. So this particular H, this NH will be replaced by OH. Okay, this H will be replaced by OH. Okay, so now after that, what we have done, we have replaced this by RX. So this OH will be replaced by X. And after that, we have hydrolyzed this. Okay, so here this phthalic acid will be formed and you will have 1 degree amine here. Right? Okay, so next is Mangius reduction. Mangius reduction, we have cyanide that has been converted into more the number. Okay, so here the Na alcohol is being used here and here. This bond will break. This particular bond will break and H2H2 will be added. Again, a very simple reaction. Very simple expected reaction. Now, we have oxymercuration and demercuration. So, what is this reaction? Let us see oxymercuration, demercuration and hydroboration oxidation. These are kind of similar. So, I'll just advise you one thing. When you have acidic hydrolysis, in that case, carbocation is formed. When we are doing, this is just the formation of OH, okay? When through alkene, we are forming the alcohol, right? So in this case, first thing is acid catalyzed reaction. In that case, carbocation is rearranged. In this case, oxymercuration, demercuration, Markovnikov rule is simply applied here. Nothing, no rearrangement here, just Markovnikov rule is applied here. These are the reagent present here, okay? Just Markovnikov rule is the end product here. Now, in hydroboration oxidation, anti-Markovnikov rule is the end product here. Okay, anti-Markovnikov means the negative part will be on more number of hydrogen. Okay, so these were the reactions. And guys, I know you all are thinking, ma'am, where is aldol condensation, cross aldol, cross canisaro, ozonol says, ma'am, we want all these questions because questions are being asked from these elements as well. Okay, so guys, what we are going to do, just listen to me. We are going to do that in next video because these aldol, cross aldol, canisaro, cross canisaro are just not key. Okay, these are the products. Because for the products, we need to know what is the alpha, beta, everything. So because of that, a detailed video on these reactions will be provided to you next week. Okay, so do let me know in the comment section what are the other reactions that you want me to make a detailed video on. Okay, then bye bye, take care, all the very best. If you like this video, do share this with your friends. Okay, that motivates me a lot. So do comment down, I always see your comments, if you like this or not, and what are the other reactions, or what are the other chemical things that you find very difficult. So I'll surely make that thing very easy for you. Bye bye, take care, have a great day.